Impenetrable, seemingly endless, and breathtakingly beautiful, the tropical rainforest. These ancient trees not only offer protection to innumerable fauna and flora, equatorial rainforests absorb approximately one-fifth of the Earth's carbon dioxide, which exists in the atmosphere as greenhouse gases. Climate change would be much harsher without these forests, but exactly how much carbon dioxide can tropical rainforests absorb? Is there perhaps a limit? Amazon FACE is a unique field experiment in the Brazilian rainforest, searching for an answer to this question. Selected areas will be artificially fertilized with carbon dioxide over 10 years in order to simulate the progression of greenhouse gases in the atmosphere. The project is planned to start this year. Scientists from different fields have come together at the INPA, National Institute of Amazonian Research in Manaus, in order to plan the project. Anja Ramig and her colleagues from the TU Munich, together with scientists from Brazil, Austria and the USA, produce so-called climate models from data gathered in the rainforest. Scientific studies will be completed on the basis of these models. Our goal here is to find out what effect climate change, and specifically the increased concentration of atmospheric carbon dioxide, will have on the rainforest, and also if the rainforest can continue to absorb CO2 in the future. Carbon dioxide is vital for plants. They use photosynthesis to convert CO2 into carbon and oxygen. Carbon is pure energy for trees in the rainforest. They bind it in their branches, trunks, and roots. Rainforests are so-called CO2 sinks. They bind much more carbon than they release. The question is whether it will stay this way.
What will become of this forest in 50 years from now, in 100 years from now? But being more specific, what the project looks to answer is the existence, the magnitude and the duration of a supposed CO2 fertilization effect in this forest as a way to increase the forest resilience against climate change here.
This project is unique. Approximately 8 plots will be built in the middle of the rainforest. Each will be surrounded by 16 steel towers. In 4 of the plots, the plants will be fertilized daily with 1 ton of carbon dioxide. We will then try to record the complete state of this ecosystem inside this ring. The carbon goes in at the top through photosynthesis, gets spread among the trees, and will be stored below in the trunk and released again through the roots. We don't just want to record individual processes, but the complete state of the system. That's the idea behind this experiment, so that we can then transfer the data to our models. The results of the FACE experiment should help to improve future predictions for existing rainforest models. Currently, many parameters are plagued by uncertainty about the actual cycle. Right now, we're taking baseline measurements, which are measurements before the experiment begins. The rainforest is the most diverse ecosystem, so you can imagine that there are endless possibilities for outcomes. And when you try to work out a mean value for a model in the present and see if the value will change in the future, then it is actually a huge challenge. For example, we have 100 different species per hectare, and each of these can react differently. In this context, our mean value can only be an educated guess. This is why research in the rainforest is so complex. Various parameters are recorded during a rainforest inventory. The moisture levels and the circumference of the tree trunks are measured, for example. Their biomass is also calculated. Soil samples are taken regularly in the forest in order to analyze its nutrient content. It is relatively low here, as the topsoil layer is only thin. It has a very different composition compared to forests in Europe. It's a lot more depleted, a lot less nutrient dense, especially in phosphorus. And the nutrients are also much more tightly packed in the soil. That's why it's almost easier for the roots to extract the nutrients from the foliage. The soil is a main focus of the project. It poses a huge mystery. The American scientist Richard Norby from the Oak Ridge National Laboratory has discovered a method to measure the growth of roots in the soil.
We really want to quantify the production of the fine roots in this system. Fine roots meaning usually like less than 1 millimeter, the size of a hair, so very fine, but they're very important in terms of nutrient uptake and water uptake and carbon cycling. One of our objectives here is to measure the overall net primary productivity of this forest. That includes measuring the stem growth and the leaf growth, but also the root growth.
For this, he uses a very light-sensitive camera attached to a 2-meter-long tube. Every 2 weeks, the camera takes a photo of the exact same root area. In this way, he can deduce whether the increased CO2 also contributes to root growth. The scientists need further funding for the big face experiment. They have already produced a small face model. In open-top chambers, smaller trees grow on the floor of the rainforest, and these are being fertilized with carbon dioxide. However, it is too early for initial results. In order to make accurate predictions for the future of the rainforest, they need the big face experiment that includes as many parameters as possible.
We are in a situation now that models can't do much. And theory can't provide as much as well if we don't have an experiment like the Amazon phase here.
Over the next 10 years, scientists will collect millions of data about the processes that take place in the rainforest and uncover its secrets. Perhaps they will discover that the ancient trees cannot absorb climate-wrecking CO2 indefinitely. But perhaps their work will also ensure that efforts to protect tropical rainforests are maximized. There is the hypothesis that vast areas of the Amazon rainforest will die off. It predicts that when the planet gets drier and warmer, despite increasing CO2 concentrations, that the rainforest will die off then.
We have many millions of people out there that need this forest, that depend on this forest, even though if they are living in cities, they think they probably don't need this forest, but they do. This forest provides a lot of ecosystem services to mankind.
Rainforests have existed for 20 million years. In the worst-case scenario, they could become CO2 emitters and cease in their role as regulators of the global climate. The Amazon Face Project could also give us the answers to if and when that might happen.